Let's talk about plate tectonics. By the end of today, you should be able to answer the question, what are the characteristics of each plate boundary? Let's go over the layers of the Earth. You have your crust, mantle, and core. The crust is super thin, and that's where we live. The upper mantle flows, convection happens here. The lower mantle is more rigid, while the outer core is liquid. The inner core is solid nickel and iron. To recap, it's crust, upper mantle, lower mantle, outer core, and inner core. Let's move on to tectonic plates. So what is a tectonic plate? If you take some crust and some cooled mantle, you have a tectonic plate. If you look at a topographic map of the world, you can see the boundaries of all the tectonic plates, which are outlined by trenches, mountain ranges, volcanoes, and ridges, such as the San Andreas Fault in California. Plate boundaries can be divided into three types. There's convergent with subduction, divergent, and transform boundaries. Convergent means two plates are moving towards each other, while subduction means that one plate goes under the other. Convergent boundaries feature mountains and earthquakes and volcanoes and trenches when there's subduction. Metamorphic rock and igneous rocks form here. When there's subduction, one tectonic plate is being destroyed. In a divergent plate boundary, two plates are moving away from each other. Features of a divergent boundary are volcanoes and particularly ridges. Igneous rock forms here. A divergent plate boundary is also responsible for adding more to a tectonic plate. A transform boundary is when two plates slide past each other. A major feature is earthquakes. There's no specific rocks that form here. Most transform boundaries are underwater, but the California San Andreas Fault is one that is above ground and clearly visible. Convection currents play an important role in plate tectonics, particularly the ones that are formed in the upper mantle as they move the tectonic plates around. The flow of the two convection currents in the mantle will cause the tectonic plates above to be convergent, while the flow in the opposite direction will cause the plates to be divergent. Now you should be able to answer the question, what are the characteristics of each boundary? That's it for now. Till next time, bye!